Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a large extraperitoneal fluid collection. You can see the abdominal cavity. The gut lobes are invisible and the fluid collection is seen in the extraperitoneal space. The fluid collection has slightly thick fluid with multiple septation in the collection. The extraperitoneal space is the portion of abdomen and pelvis which doesn't lie within peritoneum. It includes retroperitoneal space situated posteriorly to the peritoneum, retroperitoneal space situated anterior to the peritoneum. The bladder is an extraperitoneal muscular urine reservoir located anatomically in the pelvis space behind the pubic symphysis. The proximity to bone structures of the pelvis predisposes this organ to injury. A complete ultrasound of the retroperitoneum consists of scans of the kidneys, abdominal aorta, common iliac artery regions, and inferior vena cava, including any demonstrated retroperitoneal abnormality. Now you can see the collection. The collection is a huge collection, extraperitoneum collection. Now the five major peritoneal folds are the peritoneum folds into five key components: the greater omentum, the lesser omentum, the falciform ligament, the small bowel mesentery, and the mesocolon. The folds extend over the viscera and all line the abdominal cavity. The peritoneal space is bounded by the posterior parietal peritoneum anteriorly and the lumbar spine posteriorly. The retroperitoneal space contains the kidneys, adrenal glands, pancreas, nerve roots, lymph nodes, abdominal aorta, and inferior vena cava. Now again you can see the large fluid collection, and this collection measures, these are the septa which are dividing the peritoneal collection, extra peritoneal collection, into different portions. Other organs located in the intraperitoneal space are the liver, spleen, and the tail of the pancreas. In women, the uterus, fallopian tubes, ovaries, and gonadal blood vessels are located in the intraperitoneum. Now the intraperitoneum organs are stomach, half of the first part of duodenum, that is 2.2 cm, jejunum, ileum, cecum, appendix, transverse colon, sigmoid colon, and rectum, upper 1/3. Now the retroperitoneal organs, the rest of the duodenum, ascending colon, descending colon, rectum, middle 1/3. The bladder is a master at self-repair. When damaged by infection or injury, the organ can mend itself quickly, calling upon specialized cells in the lining to repair tissue and restore a barrier against the harmful materials concentrated in the urine. Now the retroperitoneal ultrasound takes approximately 45 minutes. Test times may vary due to specific physician requests. After you are in the ultrasound examination room, you will be asked to change into a gown and provide a brief history. You will then be placed on a stretcher. Again, you can see the large extra peritoneal space. The peritoneum cavity contains the omentum, ligaments, and mesentery. Intraperitoneal organs include the stomach, spleen, liver, first and fourth parts of the duodenum, jejunum, ileum, transverse, and sigmoid colon. This large collection measures about 26 cm into 21 cm. Quite a large collection and has multiple septa. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.